confidence because that's what they need right now.
So here we go, guys. The Orlando Championship on the line. Capture the flag on Heretic. First team to capture five times will win the game. Look for teams to lock down the pink tower. They'll be flanking from Carbine. And, of course, if they can control the sword, they'll get some sweet beatdowns. We're starting this game off right now with Roy from Instinct. He's making his way towards P2.
I'll tell you what, my key in this game is going to be is who can get control of the top and the middle of the map, because we've seen it in the past. Spring that middle, toss the flag out to somebody waiting on the platform, and you can do some real damage quickly. It's all about setup and control, getting those guys on, you know, on respawn, and if somebody can get out to a 2 or 3, you know, flag lead right here, that you got to just hold on to that and ride it through.
And these are two of the best teams we've seen so far this tournament on the short-range maps, being Amplified, Heretic, and Onslaught. We're watching as Instinct is struggling to start this game off, but Classic isn't. Tzoxic already in the Classic base, or already inside the Instinct base. He was pulling the flag. Two down for Classic. We're going to stay on board with Instinct.
I'll get shots on him if he pokes out.
Don't push right to him.
He's weak. He got two shots in P2.
One shot, P2. Nice shot. Got it. Stay alive.
P2 soldier. P2 again. Soldier's got a shot on him. Two P2 to hard needles.
P2 soldier's really weak.
I'm getting shot from the
P2. Pick one to hard needles right now.
Stay alive, guys. Everyone's got to stay alive. Stay alive.
There's a guy in the base.
Hide, hide, hide.
Yeah, there's a guy in the base. One shot,
pink one.
I'll get flight.
Nice shot.
Just one day.
Stay alive.
Where are they?
Stay alive.
Arm center.
Shoot
top
wing.
One shot.
P2.
P1, one shot. They're fine.
They're flagged. How's our flag? How's our flag going? Where's he going? He's going pink. Pink or flag. Pink or flag. Pink or flag.
Push your base, yo. 20 pink ones. 20 pink ones.
Your spot, for sure.
I need one. He's dead. I'll push you back to our base.
So am I.
You guys guard, at least. We're naming our base. We're
not dying. I'm not capping.
Our car, Chief. Our front jump.
I'm one shot.
Front of the base.
Pick two, guys. Maybe I'll got it. No one's trying to
top center if you can.
I can't go yet.
Pick two, yeah. Pick two, one shot.
Two guys are pink.
I got pink three.
I'm sorry, but Lunchbox is just way too good.
Yeah, I just muted myself to ask our producer down low. I was like, how good is Lunchbox playing right now? Staying alive. First off, he did the oops grenade, Scott, to clear out pick two. The double plasma taking out Ghost Yami. Stayed alive, picked up the double kill with the assassination. Now he's pushing in for a flag, and he's out there Ghost again.
He's just on fire right now. I mean, look, he's doing everything. He's slaying, he's pulling flags. Complete team play right now. Complete team play is what we're seeing out of Instinct, and that's a hard thing to overcome. Classic right now, even though it's 1-1, they've got a lot of work to do.
I'm more impressed with the teamwork of this team. If you watch the angles these guys are taking on Instinct, it's just unbelievable. They'll shoot pink two from under their base. There'll be car side shooting pink two. They always have 2 or 3 BRs on the power points at all times.
I have to say, though, Instinct definitely overextended on this last flag. It's still down P1. Roy, the last member alive, trying to keep it there. But meanwhile, Classic was able to get into the Instinct base, run a carbine, and Ghost Yami is going to be able to convert a cap off of it. We saw Instinct make that mistake earlier, and Classic is going to capitalize every time.
And that's huge. You know, and you're right. That's huge. That's exactly what they need to do right there, because that's an example of everything going your way, you're dominating, but then suddenly you make one wrong choice, one wrong decision, the other team capitalizes on it, and then you start to second guess yourself. And that's what you got to do right here, is you got to start to get into their head, make them question whether or not they're doing the right thing, maybe play a little bit more conservatively than they want to, so you can get yourself into a position to win this game. Because let's face it, if Classic doesn't win this one, it's Instinct's tournament.
And here we go, Soldier breaking up a big double kill. Now he's got his teammate running the flag. He's going to be stopped. It was Chig running it over Carbine side. We're going to jump on board with Ghost Yami when we get a chance. He's sitting in his base, and he's providing some incredible long-range fire. This is something Karma used to do for Carbine.
Yeah, Karma used to always just sit in our base and shoot Carbine. But the thing about Ghost Yami is he's such a versatile player that I would never put him in the window. I would rather him be moving around. He's a roamer.
Well, Ghost was taken out inside his window. He was taken out by Cloud, who is now running the flag. He's got Roy in front of him watching pink side, and that is the cap we wanted to see from Instinct. The flag attempt going top middle did not work out for them. I don't expect for them to try it again this game, because running it through Carbine side seems to be working perfectly.
But again, you see how quickly the momentum can shift in this game. We talk a lot of times, we make analogies towards, like, it's a heavyweight fight. You know, they're trading blows back and forth. But that's literally what's going on right here, and it's who can sustain and maintain. If you're able to put on a constant attack, constant pressure, it's going to give you the advantage. The problem is, in order to cap a flag off, and you have to overextend yourself, and then you find yourself in a situation where you're under respawn and the other team has the advantage.
Elmite Warrior making his way towards top Carbine. Meanwhile, Lunchbox trying to sit up P2. Instinct really trying to take over map control, but they're unable to do it. Classic doing a great job of locking
that. That was not nice. You shouldn't have won that.
Sorry about that, Ghost. Didn't mean to make you look bad. Lunchbox going for the stick down bottom pink. He was the only member alive for Instinct. Roy getting the God Spawn over Car 2, and he's going to be able to get in behind this Classic base, and somehow we stalled the stick there. Roy getting that flag return as Elmite stays on fire. He got a double with a sticky grenade going for the triple. He was taken down, but it allows Roy to come in there and pick up another double. Let's jump on board with Roy. Actually, good thing we didn't, because Chig just shut him down. Lunchbox sitting top middle. You see Instinct trying to spread out towards car side. But guys, this is just a free-for-all melee. Neither team able to lock down the map.
Just as soon as somebody gets control, it gets broken, or if a flag gets pulled, it's the last guy alive who's trying to guard it. It's really going to come down to who's able to capitalize. I mean, we've got about 7 minutes, 45 seconds left in regulation, and so as Lunchbox runs this flag, it's going to be a huge advantage that they're able to get it in, because it's been so back and forth all game long.
And I have to say, guys, Lunchbox had a slight fumble, but it seemed to be a lucky one because he was able to dodge a flag grenade. But once again, Ghost Yami being able to get inside the base. Soldier 187 weakened the players. Ghost was able to finish him and get the flag return. That was a clutch return for Classic. That's a momentum breaker.
Now, that's huge right there. And that's the kind of thing, it's like, if you feel like I got so close, you do so much work to get it that far, and then you're not able to capitalize, it can be demoralizing. You got to just bounce back. But Ghost seems to be that X Factor. Remember back in the day on Carbine, he was called the X Factor. He would come up with plays out of nowhere, and it's like, how did he do that? If he can continue to do that, it'll give his team some hope.
Well, he's got Magna Boots on right now, stuck by that plasma grenade. And we got Elmite Warrior with the sword. Let's go check him out. I want to see at least one Walrus Tusk beat down.
Walrus
Don't ask Tusk. Me, it's Shibby.
Okay.
And right now we have Lunchbox again going Carbine side with his flag. He's got Cloud clearing the way, and that perfect four shot on Ghost Yami is going to make it easy for Lunchbox. Here we go. This can be flag number three. Is anyone from Classic in position to stop him? Yes, Chick was there.
Ooh.
Can't Instinct get to this flag. Elmite Warrior picking up a clutch kill, and he puts it in. 3-2. Instinct takes the lead with 6 minutes, 20 seconds left in regulation time.
And again, that's big. Coming off a respawn, being in the right place, capitalized, not hesitating. You can't hesitate in that situation, and Elmite didn't.
And Lunchbox unable to connect with the beatdown. That means there's going to be two players alive at his base, one of them being Tizoxic, who is running this flag up pink 2 and back down it towards his base. Anyone in position from Instinct? No, it looks like it's going to be tied up 3-3. Here we go, guys. We have ourselves a game with 6 minutes left on the clock.
And Chig with the flag up. But I'll tell you what, Tizoxic can run that flag, man. See how quickly he was cycling that?
And Chig did it even faster, guys. Did you see how he perfectly bounced it down the ramp? That is 2 flag caps in about... I don't know, 24
got
seconds.
Flag,
flag number
about,
5 in the hands
we just
of
go
Classic.
Three in a row. Look at this. Are you kidding me?
This is just impressive.
Oh my. Oh my goodness.
And he gets it back to his base. Elmite Warrior stopping it, but it's too late. to Zoxic putting it in. Classic staying alive. And let's take a look at the stats here. 25 kills, only 19 deaths. That's a plus 6 for Soldier. Tizoxic putting up plus 3 with 17 assists. Classic really turned it on in the last minute 30 of that game, guys. They stay alive. Instinct now leads the series 5-1. All right, we're going to be going to a quick commercial break. When we come back, game 7 of the best of 11.